Good afternoon, everyone. This is Christy with Fan On Company. It's Friday, October 4th. I'm going to go over the market for the day and week with you. A little bit of pressure showing up into the corn market, down 4 cents today. You built up this pressure coming into the fact that we got the release from the Trump administration on their answer or solution to the issues with the biofuel waiver credits given for blending of ethanol. And really, to be honest, their response was not much at all. They said they wanted to be able to sell E15 year round. This was something that's been discussed for a while, so this is not a new sentiment to the market. You really thought that you were going to come out here with a bold stance on something, as President Trump tweeted a while ago that he had this big, great deal coming for the waivers that was going to be so good for the farmer, and also not put the small waiver or the small blending individuals out of business. And really, you just didn't see anything out of that. And with that, the market a little bit disappointing, coming back down 4 cents, but still up 13 and a quarter on the week. Soybeans, a lot of support coming up 4.5 cents higher on today. That's about 5 cents off the high of the day, but still nonetheless positive, up 33 and a quarter on the week. So a lot of support showing up there. There is some rumors of a wide killing freeze coming the 10th or 11th of October. We'll be watching that. We'll have to be seeing where these models are come Sunday evening. That's going to be a big deal for these markets. Informa came out and dropped their yields for corn and soybeans quite a bit. Their corn yield was down 2.1 bushel per acre at 167.5. That is below USDA, and they dropped almost two bushel per acre on soybeans to 46.5, also below USDA's current estimate on yield. So that was nice to see. Wheat market actually really quiet on the week. Chicago wheat up a penny and three quarters. Kansas City down a penny and three quarters on the day. On the week, Chicago wheat up 3.25 on the week, Kansas City down 3.5, so really very limited movement there. Biggest movement came in a Minneapolis wheat up 6.5 cents today, down 11 cents in the week, after we're running out of steam going off this lack of harvest activity for spring wheat and quality issues. You need a new story to keep this bull running, and we're just not getting that right now. When you look at the meat markets, mixed trade, live cattle and feeder cattle both kind of traded both sides of things, but on the week, live cattle up just over $2 on the week, feeders down just over $2. You got some important resistance points on the chart and price points on the chart when you look at it, but you did have cash trade come about $3 higher this week so far in the south. That's at 107 live, and you have asking of 110 live in the north, and that would be $3 higher as well. So you can see that cash trade kind of following suit and getting up there. You just need to see those futures market kind of break through those resistance points. Hog markets down 85 cents today, down 287.5 on the week with lack of China in the market, though cash trade is trending higher. And you see the cash index actually almost to $60. And so that's nice to see, but the futures just got a setback with not seeing China, big player here in export sales yesterday. Moving forward, definitely going to be watching weather forecasts to see if they bring that cold temperatures back in and keep that freeze coming for a lot of these areas. And then also be seeing kind of what we do pairing up into USDA's big crop report on the 10th. That's next week, and that's going to be a big deal for this market. I do have to close with a disclaimer. Trading futures and options involves risk loss and is not suitable for all producers. This is a solicitation. Have a great day.